Hi, you're watching Floyd Steinberg's YouTube channel. Today, ZYNADDSUBFX. That unspeakable name belongs to a software synthesizer native to Linux and also available on macOS and Windows. And I'm going to show you how to install it on your Raspberry Pi using the Raspberry Pi 400. But if you happen to have the Raspberry Pi 3 or 4, this will work as well. And yeah, for no obvious reason, I'm also going to show you how to create my favorite salad. So here we go. Okay, so let's begin by assembling the hardware. First, of course, the Raspberry Pi. I'm using the model 400 today, but as I said in the beginning, if you have the Raspberry Pi 3 or 4, you can use that as well. Next is the audio interface. This one is around 10 bucks, and I'll link it in this video's description for you. And of course, you want to use some MIDI hardware. I have the key steps here, but any keyboard will do. And yeah, this MIDI controller, the Cognito control, for controlling synth parameters like filter, frequency, resonance, and stuff. Okay, so now let's wire this all up, and then we can boot this by inserting the power plug. Let's go. So, you can't download readily compiled versions of the latest version of this synthesizer because the developers are selling the compiled version of the updated user interface. However, they're okay with you downloading the source code and compiling it yourself, so that's what we'll do today. Please remember to show your support to the developers. I'll post all the links you need in this video's description. Okay, so the first thing you want to do is to upgrade your system. So, open the console window and type in sudo apt-get update followed by sudo apt-get upgrade. This will download all the latest system software. And now, let's download the software. You can't get that from the web page because that's behind a paintwall, but on Linux you can use the open source version and you can download this from their GitHub. So now enter the line shown on the screen. Don't worry, you'll also find this in this video's description and on the official wiki page of this project. This will download all the libraries needed to compile the synthesizer. Now, download and compile the latest source codes by entering the line shown on screen now. Compiling took roughly half an hour on my Raspberry Pi 400, so while the software is compiling, why not prepare a delicious salad? Start by chopping up half a lettuce into small pieces and toss them into a bowl, like this. Also, cut two escallions into small pieces and add them to the mix. The compiler is still doing its thing, so let's roughly grate two carrots now and add them to the bowl. Oh, in the meantime, the compiler is finished, so now let's install the software by typing in these lines. Once that script has finished, you can launch the standalone version of the synthesizer by typing in ZYNADDSUBFX and pressing enter. You can also run it in your favorite digital audio workstation by adding /opt/zyn-fusion to the VST plugins path. We'll use the standalone version today and the plugin in the next video. Start QjackCTL, start the Jack daemon, and set up your audio and MIDI connections. You want to connect your MIDI devices to the synthesizer on the ALSA page and the synthesizer to the system output on the audio page. We are now ready to use the synth. Let's start by listening to some of the preset patches. Please remember supporting the developers of the user interface. If you compare this modern user interface to the old one, it's miles ahead. Before we move on to the next part, let's continue our salad. You need to cut a lime in half and squeeze out the juice. Then add 4 spoons of sugar to the mix. And now let's take a closer look at the architecture of this synthesizer. On the left side of the window there's a menu which will give you access to all the synth's engines. You can assign patches to MIDI channels in the part settings, there's a browser for finding your patches, a mixer, an editor for drum kits, an effects section, and the 3 synth engines. Each patch can use all of the synth engines available. You can turn them on or off using the buttons on the left. Add is called additive synthesizer, but in reality it's a traditional subtractive synth with a powerful wave shaping feature. Sub is called subtractive synth, but in reality it's a complex noise filter. And pad is called a pad synthesizer, but it comes closest to a traditional wavetable synthesizer. Okay, and for the end of this video, I'm going to take a brief look at the additive synthesizer, which in reality is a subtractive synth. I'm going to create a filter sweep, and I'll have a more detailed look on this in the next episode, which will release next week. Here we go. Okay, I'll finish off this video by creating a filter sweep sound using the additive or subtractive synthesizer here. So let's press a clear instrument and then go to the subtractive synth and first go to the oscillator page, select the saw wave, then you'll have a triangle wave, so we need to adjust the shape here. And now we've got this sound. Let's add a second oscillator and then make it a saw wave too. All right, adjust the shape. And now what we want to do is detune this slightly. By the way, you can use the mouse wheel on these controllers to finally adjust them. So let's listen to this now. And now we'll want to adjust the volume of this. And also switch it on the voice list. Okay. Let's listen again. You can hear there's this detuned sound. All right, now let's go to the global page and add a filter. So go to the filter page on the global page and then just dial down the cutoff frequency like this. Let's listen. Let's dial down the volume a little bit. All right, now I want some filter movement. So let's go to the envelope. Adjust this just a little bit here. So we have a filter attack. And let's listen. Okay, let's begin from the very bottom here. Let's listen again. Okay, once again. Let's have a really long attack phase. And yeah, let's listen. Okay, and now let's increase the filter resonance a little bit. This is Q. And also have an LFO doing its thing here after a short delay. This is too much. All right, and now let's add some effects. So go to the part insertion here and let's add a chorus effect. So chorus, and let's listen. This is distorted, so let's go down with the volume and the amount. And how about a little bit of delay? So this is called echo here. So let's use the echo and select one of the presets. Now I also want to remove that clicking sound at the beginning of the sound. That should be a problem with the amp amplitude. So let's add a little bit of attack phase here. Let's listen. Yep, and there you have it. Evolving pad in 2 minutes or so. And I'll have a more detailed look at this synth engine in the next episode, which will be out next week. And before we go, let's finish our salad too.
Okay, let's finish the salad by blending 2 handfuls of salted and roasted peanuts. Add them to the mix and then add 2 tablespoons of sweet chili sauce. Then mix all the components thoroughly and add some sliced roasted chicken breast to this. Vegetarians can use grilled tofu as a substitute. You're now ready to serve, and I can tell you this smells absolutely heavenly, and now I'm really, really hungry.
Yeah, and that's it for today. I hope you found this interesting and useful, and if you did, please consider subscribing to my channel, and as always, thanks for watching, and see you again very, very soon. Bye-bye!